output types for different document types, then definitely you need to maintain that combination. If you want same output type for all the different document types, you can keep it blank, which means for all the document types, it will take the same output type. No, Pradeep, there are no transports here because this will be provided directly to the end user now. So whatever configuration you have done, that was in SPRO. This particular screen will be now available to whoever you want to give the access. So for example, if you want this transaction to be given to the end user directly, so that whenever a new vendor is added, he is adding that in this table, that will be done. So there is no transport involved in this particular configuration. Yes, any questions? Yes, Manish.
Yes, so it is client specific, like if we are doing in the quality or we are doing in the production, how it is managing?
Yes, it is a client dependent, because see, this is like a master data, whatever you are doing in OPD, this is like a master data.
Okay, got it.
See, whatever configuration you done in, yeah, sorry.
Go ahead, Garu, finish it.
Yeah, whatever configuration you are maintaining, like which program will be used, which form will be used, that you can maintain in the SPRO. But once you come into the OPD, this is a screen where you can maintain the different combinations to determine the output. Now, normally this task is done by the end user, who knows that for this particular vendor, I want to provide the print. For this particular vendor, I want to have the email. So this kind of things are keep on changing on the day-to-day basis. It keeps on changing for vendor to vendor, right? So that is the reason there is no transport involved here.
Mm-hmm. So this is similar to maintaining output conditions in ECC then?
Exactly, yes.
Which is not given controlled by any transport or anything, but it is controlled by whoever the user is executing that transaction.
Yes, you are right. What is the transaction code? I don't remember that transaction code where you provide the access to the user to update that records.
In case of sales, it is VV31.
Yeah.
Yes. What about purchase?
Purchase, I think it is
MN04.
MN04, okay. Okay. Thanks.
MN04, right? Okay. Yes, this is very much similar to that particular transaction where you maintain that user will have the access, he will keep on adding the combinations, and accordingly the output will be determined. Not only the output, the receiver, like let's say for example, you have different kind of partner functions, right? What particular role? So there are some differences. You need to take care of that, because normally when you talk about the NAS, let me go to the NAS. In NAS, if I want to configure the output type and if I go for this partner functions, so the partner function VN stands for vendor here, which will be vendor number. But if you go to this particular screen, you will not find VN here, because even in SRM, whenever you want to refer the partner function VN, you need to use LF. So that thing you need to take care of, because if you write VN here, that will not work. Okay, so receiver, you can determine the output channel. Again, you can see based on the output type, currently the output channel is determined as print. So for example, if you want to have the receiver ID, let's say for a particular vendor, instead of print, I want, let's say, I want to send it as a fax or IDOC or email. So what you can do is you need to provide a role, you need to provide a receiver ID, and accordingly you can change the output channel. Okay, email settings, printer settings, like what will be the, let me just go ahead here. Yep. So printer settings, which will be the print queue, how many copies you want, that also you can specify here in this condition table. Email settings, email receivers, and finally the form templates. So you can specify all these things here. Only difference is earlier you were maintaining these things through NAS and some other transactions. But now, because as I told you, the target architecture of SAP S/4HANA is Adobe Document Server. For Adobe Document Server, you need to work on the Adobe Forms rather than the smart forms and the SAP scripts. So as of today, Adobe Forms plus SAP scripts plus smart forms all are supported. But going forward, once this becomes the developed product, once the new output determination is completely full-fledgedly available, which can be used for all different kind of scenarios, SAP will stop supporting SAP scripts and smart forms. Only Adobe Document Server will be available, and for that, you have only this option, new output determination. You cannot use the old output determination for the Adobe Forms. Right? Any questions?
Gaurav, this is Vijay. I have one question. And in traditional ECC, the output determination works based on the condition technique, right? And where you have a condition types, access sequences, and then tables. And you can even modify the tables using the field catalog and all that. Can we do that here? Can we add more fields?
Yes, yes, yes. From the technical point of view, it is possible. So even in ECC, if you want to modify, you were like writing the code, right? Or it was directly something you were doing?
No. Yeah, we can, once you go to the table, you can append the tables or you can create your own tables. Like you added purchase organization and document type here. And other than company code and purchase organization document type, you can add more fields to that using, from the field catalog. Can we do that here by adding to the structures? Usually functional guys will do it.
Yes, I understand that. But let me see. Because these condition tables are totally different. So let me just go to purchase order and let's go for
output types. Yeah.
Yes, output types. And here you want to add the conditions. So already these columns are provided.
Yes. If we want to get more columns other than what was standard.
Okay, yeah, these so these are the columns that are supported. Yes.
Yeah.
So I think this is a structure. This is, I think, just a minute. We have not tried this, but I think this is a structure which you can change to add the new fields.
Oh, okay.
Let me see. It is only allowing these combinations as of now. This is the result one. So conditions are only this ones which are supported, and I got your point. Let me check on this. There is some possibility from
structure.
Yes, I got it. So it is only allowing 6 fields as of now, but what if you want to add new fields into this? Right.
Exactly. We could do that.
Yeah, that is probably we need to go to the take that structure and go to SE11 or something and then add it. Probably that will show up here, I guess. You can try it.
No. It's not from SE11. It'll be in the condition technique only.
Right.
There is something called a field catalog. And
but in future, in this one, I don't know where it is going to be.
Yes. See, from technical point of view, definitely yes, because this is a structure. So from structure, if you are going from the technical side, you can definitely add the fields. But we need to check from the functional point of view, like we were adding the condition techniques, whether that thing is possible here or not. I will confirm on that.
Yeah, condition tables creation is by the functional guys. It's not technical. So that's that. From the field catalog, you can bring into and create a new tables, or you can append the tables in ECC. That's what I was thinking. And one other question, it's a general question, Gaurav. BRF plus and OPD, there are synonyms transactions, or there is a variation in both of them?
No, they are two different transactions. Although this functionality is called as BRF plus, but if you go to BRF plus transaction, it is to upload the applications. It will show you which applications are available. As I've shown you that if you want to import.
Yeah, only XML file import.
Yes. Otherwise, from BRF plus, you cannot do this configuration. This configuration has to be done from OPD.
Okay, so the overall OPD also be under BRF, is it?
Yes, the functionality, overall functionality is BRF plus. Under BRF plus, there are different transactions. Although BRF plus is also the transaction, but it is not only transaction, it is a functionality also.
Okay.
Okay, so now I think we already seen when you create a purchase order, and if a new purchase order is determined, let me see this one, or let me just come out of this. We already understood this now, the difference between the two screens. Okay, so now if I go for a new purchase order, whatever things we determined, they should be available in the messages screen. Okay, earlier it was showing completely blank, but now it should show the values. Still not showing. So S log and all, this is fine. It's see, as of now it is still not able to determine anything. We need to find a reason why it is not showing anything, which output type should be used, which receiver. I think we changed the settings which were not activated. I think we activate this and then go on to the display mode. This is which one? Yeah, this is 1610. I hope this is also 1610. Yes. Let me come out of this. Okay. Still not able to determine. Let's see why. Disorder. Type. So currently it is, if the purchase organization is S-log, then it should determine the purchase order. This is perfectly fine. Then why it is not working? I need to check this, because as I told you, BRF Plus is properly activated or not. That is one question mark, because earlier it was not showing anything. Now it is allowing us to add the output types. It is allowing us to do the configuration, but still it is not working here. Okay, let me just try to add manually. Okay, if I add this output type as purchase order, this is my receiver, which means my vendor. Channel I want to print, country IN, language EN, and form. Let's see if this is working. Let's go back. No, this is still not activated properly. Otherwise this error should not have come. So what I'll do is I'll just check with this, the technical team, that BRF Plus files, XML files are uploaded properly so that we can use this functionality. So I'll show you this particular scenario, how to print, how it gets printed. The print part is exactly the same, because forms, programs, they're still available in the same way. Only the difference will be that the screen that you can see in the messages, that will be different, and this is getting determined from the new output determination. Okay, let's try to do this. I don't think it will work. Yes, it is still not working. Okay, apart from this, whatever we discussed today, any questions? Yes.
Actually, I'm kind of confused. The setting which we did in SPR. Okay, what is the control for that, and what is the control for OPD check?
Yes, I'll just give you the overview. See, okay, let me take 5-10 minutes to explain whatever we discussed, because we discussed a lot of things, just to make sure that you understand each and everything. So in ECC, we were doing the output determination using transaction MACE. In SAP S/4HANA 1610, SAP has provided the new output determination and SAP has provided the option. If you want to go back to NAS, that is also possible. So either you use NAS or you use the new output determination, that is up to you. Now, if you are going with new output determination, you need to configure the new output determination from OPD screen, in which you will be setting the rules. Now, this rules will be set up by the user directly. Okay. Apart from that, there is also some configuration, like which program will be used, which form will be used. That is not something which will be controlled by the user. User will only control whether for this particular vendor, I want to send it as a print, or I want to send this as a email, or I want to send it as a fax. Okay, at the same time, whether I want to send it immediately or I want to send it in the, as a scheduled job. So this type of things will be handled by the user. But apart from that, there are also some settings like assigning the program, assigning the forms. That will be done using the screen in SPRO. So in SPRO, there is SAP Reference IMG, Cross Application Components. Within this, you have output control and these things I'm talking about. So in this particular thing, assign form templates, you will be specifying the program name, you will be specifying the form routing and the form that you want to use, form template ID. Okay, so this is the configuration that you are doing from SPRO, while the rules are directly maintained in OPD. You can go to OPD from this transaction also. And also one important thing, whatever output channels you want to use, you need to make sure that they are configured from here. Because if you don't want the user to use fax, let's say that is not allowed. So you can come here and you can deactivate fax from here. You will not assign fax as an option for purchase order. Then from the front screen, from the OPD screen, user will not be able to assign the fax. Okay, that part you can control from SPRO, while for a particular vendor, what needs to be done, that can be done from OPD. Right, this is something you are asking, Arijit. What is the difference between SPRO config and the OPD config?
Yes, sir.
Okay, another important thing, just the recap. If you want to use the new output determination, in OPD, you will not be able to perform the rule setup till the time BRF XML files are not uploaded. So although that activity is from the technical consultant, but what happens is when SAP has delivered this new output determination, nobody was knowing this. Many consultants, they were just trying to go to OPD and they were getting this error and they were not sure what to do. So just keep in mind, if you are getting that type of error, this means that BRF plus file is not uploaded, XML file is not uploaded in BRF plus. So that is the reason I told you that you can go to BRF plus and see the application. Now again, the problem is you will be only able to see the application if you have uploaded the file. Okay, otherwise from the table level, you can check whether the file is uploaded or not. I'll check if I can show you that table from where you can see whether the file is uploaded or not. But it is a one-time activity. If your technical team has done it properly, then you will not find that issue. Now in 1610 also, from last 2-3 batches we are using this server, we never find this error. Why we are finding it now? Because we have completely reset the server. Even the company codes which were available, they are completely deleted now. That is the reason that BRF plus setup is still not complete. That is the reason we are not able to do this activity here. That is only one time activity that needs to be done by the basis consultant. Okay, any other questions?
So, OPD transaction,
yes.
It is also available from the SPRO screen. So, for example, if
you know, Arijit, your voice is not clear. There is some background noise.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. Yes, sir. OPD transaction, it is also available from the SPRO screen. Now, for example, if you want some different settings, the consultants have to configure that for the user, or the user can do different combinations at their own end.
No, SAP has actually provided this OPD directly to be accessible by the user also. So even if SPRO access is not available, user can directly go to transaction OPD because it will not involve any kind of transports. So OPD can be accessible to the users and users can do the changes whatever they want. They don't need to be relied on the consultants. And also, if you are working on cloud, okay, in on-premise, they are still not provided the app to configure this. But in cloud, there is already the app which is available, which will allow you to perform this OPD changes directly from Fiori app. So you don't need to go to traditional GUI and enter the transaction OPD. You can directly do that from one of the Fiori app. Yes, as I told you, as of now, you'll not be able to see the business benefit. The reason why they have come with the new output determination is that going forward, the old technologies of SmartForm and SAP scripts will not be available. Because these technologies were slow. Now everything will be available on Adobe Document Server. So from the business point of view, they will definitely not able to realize the benefit. But yes, speed point of view, the way in which the output is determined in the background, maybe in the seconds, but definitely there will be some kind of improvements.
Okay.
See, business point of view, there are, for all the functionalities, you will not be able to see the business benefits because the whole purpose of this product, SAP S/4HANA, is same functionalities, how they can make it more simple. Simple in the terms of not only for the users to do the transactions. Anyways, yes, from Fiori point of view, users will also feel comfortable. But there are some things which are only to make sure that from the backend point of view, the performance is improvised. So user may not be able to see the benefit, but definitely from the system performance point of view, this will definitely add the benefit once it is full-fledgedly available. As of now, this is still under development and there are a lot of improvement areas which are every now and then from 15.11 to 16.10, you will find a lot of changes. Even when you go from 16.10 to 17.10, again, you will see a lot of changes in the output determination. So as of now, that is the main reason why they need to roll back the NACE and they provided NACE available for the output determination because it is still under the development. But going forward, yes, once it is available as a full functionality, definitely it has a benefit over the traditional condition-based techniques. Also, one important thing, all the condition-based techniques, according to SAP, in the background, they are very slow. And that is the reason the successor is BRF Plus. So as of today, we are only talking from the output determination point of view. But wherever condition-based technique is used in pricing, in taxation, wherever it is used, the plan is to bring the BRF Plus functionality as a replacement of condition-based techniques. But that will take time. So that is the whole idea.